I'm Brian Westbrook with GeekWire Studios here at AWS reInvent, joined by Norm Marks, Global Vice President of the Automotive Industry for NVIDIA. Big week, big conference. What are your first impressions?
Oh, big week indeed, and physical AI has been the heart of the topic for me in 2 days so far, so it's been very exciting. And the announcement, of course, yesterday really leads us to what we're going to talk about. So yeah, it's been terrific.
Yeah, let's talk about it. How does NVIDIA Cosmos accelerate end-to-end autonomous vehicle deployment development when deployed on AWS at massive scale? Take us down that road, if you would.
Yeah. So firstly, Cosmos World Foundation models are used to generate world states, and then these world states can be trained and tested for end-to-end autonomous vehicle software stacks. Now, the scale piece is significant. Customers who are bleeding edge working on this, we're talking about scale of 100,000 GPUs. So having that level of scale available at AWS is important to all of our automotive customers. What I think is even more exciting with the announcement of Cosmos NIM available just yesterday on AWS, now it's really a full stack solution for automotive customers. They've got the GPU, but also CPU, networking, and now the software stacks all available on AWS.
The full package available on AWS. That's fantastic. Let's talk about the advantages that Cosmos WFMs bring to AV simulation. We're talking about real-time, multi-camera, video being fed into large-scale synthetic models. How does that all work? Where do we begin? How do we wrap our head around such a pardon the pun, global expression?
One, it's a huge challenge. I mean, to test AV models, you need to test as many as 100 million scenarios. Many of these, of course, involve those rare and dangerous corner cases that we don't see in the wild very often. So Cosmos Transfer, in particular, can generate these rare and dangerous corner cases, and most importantly, it can also generate infinite variations of them. So imagine we could have one ego vehicle, the autonomous vehicle, driving on a highway with two other vehicles, but then we can generate variations of that. If the drive was in the day, now it can be raining, it could be snowing, it could be windy. We can introduce different traffic dynamics. There could be five vehicles versus others. So Transfer allows us to create thousands and, in fact, infinite variations. And then those, of course, get fed into the simulation scenario. So it's a way to create controllable AV simulations.
You talked about Transfer. Explain to us a little bit between Cosmos Reason and Cosmos Predict.
Sure. Well, let's start with Predict. What Predict can do is generate 30 seconds of video data of these world states that then can be trained and fine-tuned for the model. Now, these can be prompted from a variety of different ways. It could be a text prompt, an image prompt, or even a video prompt. So we could feed it, say, 7 seconds of video, and then generate the next 30 seconds of what we would expect the vehicle to do afterwards. So that's Predict. And these are the models that can be fine-tuned really as we move from what we think of as AV 1.0 was trained on labeled image data to AV 2.0 trained on video data in these end-to-end models. Cosmos Predict is at the core of that. Cosmos Reason, two very interesting things that it does for us with respect to AV. The first thing is around data generation. So in AV 1.0 with labeled image data, you would draw bounding boxes around the car, the pedestrian, et cetera. Well, it's very different in a video model. What you actually have to do is describe the scene. So that scene that I described, one ego vehicle on a highway with two or three other vehicles, well, what Cosmos Reason does is it looks at these either real world data or the generated data, and it actually captions and embeds the scene so we know what's in that 30 second clip. So that's one function of Cosmos Reason. We're getting absolutely terrific feedback from our customers that are already deploying this on its accuracy and the time savings that it's bringing them. The second, and what's even more exciting, is Reason is going to be at the core of what we're now calling AV 3.0, reasoning VLAs that can actually understand and reason through how to drive in a scenario. So to round it out, if you think about AV 1.0, we detected images. AV 2.0, we're predicting. And in AV 3.0, we're reasoning our way to how to drive autonomously.
That is incredible, and I imagine it doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure out that this really accelerates the growth towards autonomous vehicles of all kinds, not
it
just
sure
those
does.
That drive on the road.
Yeah, I mean, recently we just announced all the new partnerships for L4, yeah. The really exciting ones with Uber, Lucid, and Stellantis together. And this development is at the core of it. It's what's giving the industry confidence. And to your point, it absolutely is going to bring L4 to market that we've all been waiting for in a much more accelerated fashion.
Absolutely incredible. Let's get back to that partnership with AWS and NVIDIA. Why is it so important to unlock all of these models and these tools for all customers on AWS?
Well, I mean, we want to make it easy for our customers to consume. So by getting the models themselves available at AWS in these NIMs, our NVIDIA Inference Microservices, or via containers, makes it very easy for our customers to consume. We're working very closely with the AWS team, I actually just left them, and partnering together with these customers to help them be successful at actually using the models as well. So we want to make it easy to consume, but then we want to work together as one team to help our customers optimize and get the most out of the software stack development.
And at the end of the day, accelerate software development, get those products out to market faster, and then just change the world that we live.
That's
Norm
right.
Marks, thank you so much for taking
thank
the time. I know
much.
You're a busy guy. I'm Brian Westbrook with GeekWire Studios. Thanks for watching.